whether you teach virtually all year or find yourself teaching virtually in short stints of the year, we all are facing a common dilemma. How do you get kids to show up to the live meetings? What incentives would motivate them to log on? Many teachers have tried a variety of techniques. Maybe they give points for participation and attendance, and those points then earn them different rewards. Maybe a no homework ticket, or maybe they can change their virtual background. Maybe a virtual lunch with their teacher. For many of us, these work for a little while, but what we really need are more ideas. Just other things to mix it up, right? To vary the incentives. So let me mention several others, and some of these might be new to you. Okay, so one of the things we want to honor is kids are at home alone. And so the socialization of a live session is what we might want to go for. And so seeing their peers, but enjoying their time. In other words, it's fun and funny. So some have done dress up days, or they've done virtual background days or show and tell days. And all of these are great. So promote them as upcoming. But rather than guessing what the dress up day should be, why don't you just ask the kids, how do you want to dress up? Rather than telling them this is what show and tell will be, why don't you ask them, poll them. What do they want to show each other? Now they're more invested and more motivated. Okay, here's another kind of category, something that wouldn't happen on a daily basis, but if you promote it in the meetings, the newsletters, the emails that are coming up before it, we might get them to come to this one. And so some of those bigger, less frequent kinds of things would be a surprise guest. A surprise guest. And if you teach your virtual classroom from within the school building, then it could be the custodian or maybe a secretary, the school nurse. If you are doing your virtual teaching from your own personal home, then send your Zoom link or your Google Meet to the PE teacher, their favorite recess monitor, whomever, again, to pop in and surprise them. Another way to kind of surprise them or motivate them to show up would be to be promoting something coming up. And so that might be, we're going to have a surprise location. Usually we make the students sit at a table, a desk, the kitchen counter, something with a hard flat surface for their device. Well, maybe you tell them during the such and such meeting, I'm going to announce a surprise location. And one of these could be, all right, everybody, today I want us to have our class discussion from your bed. Everybody, right now, take your device and go to your bed. And so now again, new environment, and it's just something that kind of spices it up a little bit. The secret, though, is to promote these things that will be coming up. Here's another one. A lot of teachers, it's normal in the traditional classroom to have a class pet. Some pet that each student takes turns bringing to their own home. You know, they do have virtual class pets now. Yeah. And so in this upcoming meeting, we're going to get an update on our class pet. There's incentive to show up. But let me end with a few other ideas from a final category. And that is the best incentive is to have engaging instruction delivered by an enthusiastic instructor. So I remind you, when you're delivering these live lessons or facilitating these whole class discussions, make sure you're standing up. Why? More energy. Lean into the camera occasionally. Be fun and funny. Remember our job, edutaining. And if you can bring some of that fun into the content you're delivering, all the better. Let me give you some examples here. Let's say we're doing some things in math where we're working with three-dimensional objects. And so you've been laying the foundation. We've been teaching this. And so today you say, all right, you guys, here's what I'd like you to do. I'm going to give you 40 seconds. I want you to run around the house and find as many spherical objects as you can to bring back to the webcam. You got 40 seconds. Leave the volume up. I'll count it down. Go. Or maybe you're working on measurements and you want something that's so long, or you want something that's maybe so heavy. Hey, maybe you're doing an ELA lesson. And so you say, I want you to find at least one object to bring back in the next 40 seconds, 60 seconds, 30 seconds that you can give me one adjective and a specific or precise noun for, or find an object that you can bring and give me its proper noun name. And so they go and they come back. Do you see how they're up and moving now? Do you see how this is edutaining? All right. And so I don't have to give them a no homework ticket. They're learning, but they're engaged, right? That kind of participation. Let me propose another. I will often suggest to teachers that they ask kids to submit photos. School appropriate photos of themselves at home, selfies, holidays, weekends, just fun and funny photos of them. And they submit them. And then I announce, promote it ahead of time, that, hey, during our ELA lesson on Thursday, I'm going to be using your photos, photos you guys submitted of yourselves. And so then they go up on your screen, and maybe you're going to ask kids to write compound sentences based on the content in the photo, or sentences that include prepositions, or again, whatever grammar skill you've been working on. But now the content they're writing about is fun. It's funny. It's edutaining. Hey, you guys, we all have the same goal in mind, and that is to motivate our students to show up to the meetings. Why? Because I can't teach if they don't attend, right? So let's really look for ways to spice it up, some variety to motivate and give them incentives to log on each day.